Welcome to Spring Break 2021. Which is crazy, because wasn't it just spring break? Like, a month ago? How has it been a year since?
If I get corona, I get corona. At the end of the day, I'm not gonna let it stop me from partying.
You would think Gen Z learned their lesson from last year's beach crowds that contributed to massive outbreaks that spread, well, everywhere. This is what has been going on in Florida in the past few weeks. We're talking to spring breakers and those who have opted out.
It doesn't really bother me. I'm not really worried about what the virus will do to me.
Yeah, so me and my friends are going on spring break.
I didn't go to Miami when a bunch of my friends went because I am scared of COVID.
So what is already happening? And what can we expect as more schools go on spring break? Well, Miami was expecting crowds from more than 200 colleges to visit for spring break, which explains the massive crowds flooding the streets, beaches, and clubs right now. The state has much more relaxed guidelines due to Florida Governor Ron DeSantis blocking local governments from enforcing some public health orders, like closing bars or restricting restaurant capacity. They also can't fine people for refusing to wear a mask. These spring break crowds got so large and unruly that this happened.
Miami Beach police using pepper balls and brute force to break up the party.
The larger crowds we've learned have resulted in more than 900 arrests and the seizure of 80 firearms.
So what have schools done to at least try and prevent students from engaging in activities like these and these and these? Well, at least 67 colleges and universities have changed their schedules to eliminate a week-long break, and many opted for sporadic wellness days to reduce the risk of spread. UC Davis is paying students $75 to stay home over spring break. Students can apply for a staycation grant if they stay in Davis and get a COVID test. USC is one of the schools that opted for sporadic wellness days instead of a spring break. So I spoke to a student to see what their reaction to this change in schedule is.
I think that it's a good idea, but I don't necessarily think that it's working because I know this past week a bunch of USC kids went to Cabo and some went to Miami, and people are still traveling, even though it's for a shorter amount of time. Most people don't have classes on Friday, so people are going Thursday to Sunday, and just, I guess it's a long weekend, but they're still traveling and partying and breaking the COVID guidelines.
Haley didn't travel when her friends decided to, but when you're a college student who's been inside their bedroom all winter on Zoom, it's hard to fight that FOMO urge to let loose a little.
I guess people's sides of the story is this has been going on for a year. People wanna have fun. People wanna go out. People wanna do things. We're sick of just sitting home. And I mean, a lot of the people who I know went on spring break have already had COVID. So they're like, we can't get it again. We may as well have fun, which I guess is a fair reasoning. And then the people who haven't had COVID are like, if I get it, I'll be fine. I'm young. I'm not going home to my parents. I guess it's pretty selfish, but at some point people have to live their lives.
Now, Northwestern University, go Cats, is having a week-long spring break, but is encouraging people to stay safe and follow CDC guidelines. Student Sawyer Scheitler is thrilled that NU didn't opt for the singular wellness days.
Because I think any college student would agree that they need a long break to really get like the reboot that they need to finish up the school year, and having like sporadic wellness days just like doesn't really cut it, in my opinion. Or at least for me, it wouldn't cut it.
Are you traveling for spring break?
Yeah. So me and my friends are going on spring break, but it was really important for us to make sure to set the standard of, if we're going to do this, we're going to do it correctly. Because I think that's extremely important that you aren't going to either another country or another state where you're putting people at risk. So like for me, for instance, me and my friends are going to Mexico, and we have like no indoor dining policy, no clubs, nothing like that. Try to stay outside as much as we can. We're trying to avoid anything like spas or anything that would be inside other than a restaurant, and just making sure we have our masks on at all the appropriate times. And not like partying with like large groups of people. We're really just gonna try to hang out, just me and our roommates together.
Hold on, can spring break travel be COVID safe? The internet seems to be okay with it, but what if you have the antibodies or are already vaccinated? The CDC issued a statement saying fully vaccinated people can now safely engage in many activities, including gathering indoors without masks with other fully vaccinated people. However, they still advise everyone to avoid non-essential travel. Is anyone listening to that, though? Not really. TSA screenings have topped 1 million every day since March 11th, marking the highest travel volumes in a year. It seems like people just really want to go to the beach. Speaking of beaches, I wonder what Floridians think about the lax restrictions.
For me, it's great. Everyone, it seems like, eased up a little bit this semester. My life didn't change much. My college life from before, like this year and all the COVID stuff happened compared to last year, it's pretty similar. It was comparable. I mean, was it a little annoying at the beginning? Yeah, but I had come to school late anyway, so I missed most of the like being in the apartment all the time thing. I missed that. So that was only for like 3 weeks, and then every place around here started opening up. And originally it started with just like tables where people sat at, but like everything was kind of open. But from there, it just kind of went on to like the regular club bar scene that we usually have. It took about all of 4 weeks to get back to normal. And then I won't lie, like I got it. All my friends had it. I mean, we all got it. We're all fine now.
Okay, so it looks like UF canceling their spring break and instead extending their winter break a week longer didn't really affect students' plans. Mitchell has been traveling all around Florida on weekends.
So it doesn't really bother me. I'm not really worried about what the virus will do to me. Personally, I'm worried about what it would do to my family that's older than me. So the only time it ever mattered was like the few weeks before I went home. So, as it still does. But yeah, I was never really nervous about it.
Well, all I can say is,
we want people to have a good time on spring break, but don't put your guard down completely. Just be prudent a bit longer. We are going in the right direction. We're almost there.
That's all for now. Enjoy your spring break, wellness days, or whatever free time you have, but wear your mask. I'm Lindsay Tanney with YR Media.